Hi students, welcome to math class. Today we are going to continue the previous chapter, that is tangents and secant to a circle. Yesterday we solved some problems in exercise 9.2. Today we will solve some problems in exercise 9.2, so that is second one. Two concentric circles are radii. So radii means the plural form of radius. Plural form of radius is a radii. Okay, right. So two concentric circles are radii, 5 cm and 3 cm are drawn. Find the length of the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. So here, so first of all, two concentric circles. So what is the concentric circles? So concentric circles means two circles having the same center of the point, So this is the, this is a circle. And also it is also other circle, it is having the center, this one. So two circles having the same center, then these two circles we call as a concentric circles. So one is the larger circle and the other is a smaller circle. So larger circle radius is 5 centimeters, and the larger circle radius is 3 centimeters. This is a 3 centimeters. Now find the length of the chord. So chord means line joining any two points on a circle. So this is a chord, this is also chord. So find the length of the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. Okay, so a chord is a touches the smaller circle, and that is have the chord of the larger circle. Okay, now this is a 5 centimeters radius, this is 3 centimeters radius. Now we draw a chord of the larger circle. So this is the chord of a larger circle, and also it is touch the smaller circle. So this is the radius of the smaller circle, that is the 3 centimeters. This is the touches the smaller circle. So if a line touches the circle, then that is we call as a tangent to a circle. So this is a tangent of the line. So here tangent line and the radius are perpendicular to each other. So here form how much angle? 90 degrees form. Then what we are find out? Length of the chord. This is we are find out. Length of the chord. AB is we are find out. Okay. Now this is the radius. So this is the ABC. OC is a perpendicular line on AB. Now OC is a radius of the smaller circle. This is 3 centimeters. So this is the OB. OB is equal to OA. That is the radius of the larger circle. That is 5 centimeters. So here, this is the bisect the AB. And that means AC is equal to BC. AC is equal to BC. That is AB is equal to AC plus BC. AB is equal to AC plus BC. This both are same. Okay, right. Now we observe, see here. Let us we take a triangle OBC is a right triangle. Triangle OBC is a right angle because of, so here right angle is formed. Right angle is formed. So it is a hypotenuse. It is a side. It is a side. So hypotenuse, we know the Pythagoras theorem, that is a hypotenuse square, that is a OB square is equal to side square plus side square, that is a OC square plus BC square. So what is a OB square? OB square is a, that is a 5 centimeters, that is a 5 square is equal to OC is a 3, that is 3 square plus BC square. Now 5 square is a 25, that is equal to 3 square is a 9 plus BC square. Now that is a 25 plus 9, we will say we are transposing to LHS, we will get a minus 9 is equal to BC square. So 25 minus 9 is a 16, that is equal to, so here BC square, so square we are sending to other side, we will get a square root. So that is a square root 16 value is a 4. So therefore BC is equal to 4 centimeters. So BC is a 4 centimeters. So here OC, this is a C point. C point divides the AB in two equal parts. So this is a 4, this is also 4. And that means length of the chord AB is equal to 4 plus 4. That is a 8 centimeters. So length of the chord AB is equal to AC plus BC, that is a 4 plus 4 is equal to how much? 8 centimeters. Okay? Right. Now, so here, radius of a larger circle is a 5 centimeters. Radius of the smaller circle is a 3 centimeters. And now, we are observing here, in triangle BOC, angle OCB is equal to, that is how much? 90 degrees. Because we know tangent and radius are perpendicular to each other. And OB is a 5 centimeters, OC is a 3 centimeters. Now we are applying the Pythagoras theorem, that is OB square, hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. So hypotenuse is a OB, that is equal to side is a OC square plus another side is a BC square. Now OB is a how much? 5. That is a 5 square is equal to OC is a how much? 3. That is 3 square plus BC square. So 5 square is a how much? 25. So here that is equal to 3 square is a plus 9. So plus 9 is our plus 9 is we are transposing to LHS. So this is a positive quantity. So positive quantity we will send to other side, we will get a negative quantity, that is a minus 9 is equal to BC square. Now 25 minus 9 is 16, that is equal to BC. So here square, so square is we are sent to LHS, that is we will get a square root 16. So square root 16 value is a 4, that is a BC is equal to 4. But so here AB is equal to, so BC is equal to and also length of the AB. Length of the AB, that is equal to 2 into BC, that is equal to 2 into 4, that is equal to 8 centimeters. So the length of the chord the length of the chord is equal to 8 centimeters. Therefore length of the chord is equal to 8 centimeters. So here because AC is equal to BC, so here OC is bisect the AB. So here OC, that is a C. C is bisects AB. Bisects AB. AC is equal to BC. AC is equal to BC. Now AB is equal to AC plus BC. So here in this AC we can be written as AC equal to BC. So we are substitute in AC plus BC plus BC. BC plus BC is how much? 2BC. Okay, na? Right. So, AB equal to 2BC. AB equal to 2BC. So, 2 into 4. 4, 4. That is the 8 centimeters. Okay. Next problem, fourth one. So, next third problem is prove that the parallelogram circumscribing a circle is a rhombus. So, prove that the parallelogram circumscribing a circle is a rhombus. And so, here A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. It is the circumscribing a circle. Then ABCD is a, we are sure that the rhombus. ABCD is a rhombus. How do we are sure that the rhombus? ABCD is a rhombus when parallelogram is a circumscribing a circle. Now we observe, so here ABCD is a parallelogram and also it is a point, it is the center of the circle. So this is the radius. So here AB touches the circle at this point. So this is we take P, and also it is also point of this is the point of contact. It is also point of contact Q. It is a R. It is a point of contact. It is also S, point of contact. Now we observe, we know the length of the tangents drawn from external point to a circles are equal. The length of the tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. So suppose this is we take this is the A point, it is a point of contact is C. So it is B. So length of AB is equal to length of BC. Length of AB is equal to length of BC. Now so here let's see, here we are observe this is a tangent, this is the external point of the circle, B is the external point of the circle, then BP and BQ are tangents, BP and BQ are tangents, they are equal, yes, because the length of the tangent from the length of the tangent drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. So that is the BP is equal to BQ, BP is equal to BQ, and also so here AP is equal to AS. So the A is the external point to a circle, A is the external point to a circle, A is the external point to a circle, then AP is equal to AS, AP is equal to AS. Now B is the external point to a circle, then tangents BP is equal to BQ, BP is equal to BQ. Now C is the external point to a circle, then CR is equal to CQ, CR is equal to CQ. Now D is the external point to a circle, then that is the DR is equal to DS, DR is equal to DS. Now this is will take 1, 2, equation 3, equation 4. We are adding this ones, adding 1, 2, 3 and 4, we will get AP plus BP plus CR plus DR is equal to AS plus BQ plus CQ plus DS. Now we are rearrange this like this one. We are rearrange this like AP plus BP is a one set plus CR plus DR is equal to AS plus CQ plus DS. AS plus DS plus BQ plus CQ. Now, so here you observe here AP plus BP is how much? AB. BQ plus QC is BC. AS plus SD is AD. CR plus DR is CD. So here AP plus BP, AP plus BP is AB plus CR plus DR, CR plus DR is CD, that is equal to AS plus DS, AS plus DS, that is the AD, plus BQ plus CQ, that is the BQ. Now, we know in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. We know in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. That means AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CD. So here, in a CD place, we put the AB. So AB is equal to AB. And also, AD is equal to BC. AD is equal to, so here BC, BQ plus CQ is the BC. So AD plus, AD equal to BC. So here in BC, we substitute AD. AB plus AB is 2AB. That is equal to AD plus AD is 2AD. So here 2 to cancel, we will get it. AB is equal to AD. Now, so here AB is equal to AD. This side, and that means adjacent sides are equal. Adjacent sides are equal. So here AB is equal to AD. Now AD is equal to BC. But now AB is equal to BC because AD is equal to BC. AB is equal to AD. Now we know the in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. That is AD is equal to BC. So BC also, BC is equal to also AB. So therefore, and also this is also equal to AB. So hence AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA. So therefore, so that means adjacent sides are equal. In a parallelogram, adjacent sides are equal, then that is a rhombus. Okay, na? Right. Now, so here, so given a circle with the center O and ABCD is a parallelogram, it is a circumscribed circle, and let P, Q, R and S are the points of contact. Now, what is the RTP? What is the required to prove? ABCD is a rhombus. ABCD is a rhombus. How do we prove? So, here let A will take an external point to a circle. Then, AP and AC are tangents. So, tangents are drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. So, that is AP is equal to AC. So, this is we take number one equation. Next, we take B is an external point to a circle. Then, BP is equal to BQ. And C is external point to a circle, then that is CR is equal to CQ, that is third equation. Next, D is external point to a circle, then that is DR is equal to DS. So, this is the fourth equation. Next, we are adding 1, 2 and 3, 4. Now, we are adding 1, 2, 3 and 4. So that is AP plus BP plus CR plus DR, that is LHS RR adding and also RHS LR adding. Then we get that is AP plus BP plus CR plus DR is equal to AS plus BQ plus CQ plus DS. So here we are rearranging this one, this like that is AP plus BP CR plus DR is equal to AS plus DS. AS plus DS plus BQ plus CQ. Now AP plus BP is a AB. AP plus BP is a AB. And also CR plus DR. CR plus DR is a CD. That is equal to AS plus DS, AS plus DS, totally that is AD plus BQ plus BQ plus CQ, totally that is BC. Now, in a parallelogram, we know opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are that is AB is equal to CD and also AD is equal to BC. So, here we substitute in a CD place AB, in BC place AD. So, that is AB plus AB is equal to AD plus AD. So AB plus AB is 2AB. AD plus AD is 2AD. So here 2 2 is cancel. We will get AB is equal to AD. AB is equal to AD. Now AB equal to AD. That is the adjacent sides are equal. Adjacent sides are equal. That is AB is equal to AD. And also, so here AD equal to BC. Therefore, AB is equal to also BC. Okay, right. And also AD is equal to CD. So AB is equal to this is a CD because opposite sides are equal. So that is a it is AB. So we know the AB equal to AD. So this is AD is equal to CD. So therefore, hence AB equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD. So in a parallelogram, adjacent sides are equal. Then that is a rhombus. Therefore, ABCD is a rhombus. So parallelogram ABCD is a rhombus. Hence proved. Okay, right.